Right. We have another question here. This one, x squared minus 11x equal to 0. So this is what we're going to do. This one. Okay, let's just. Okay, this, not this one. Okay, is this question we're going to do? Now, it is important to note that whenever we see this statement next to this equation, or that's the equation, understand that we don't need to factorize the equation because the equation is not factorizable. So we can solve this by using the quadratic equation or by completing the square. So here is the equation, 1.1.2, that says 2x squared minus 11x plus 7 equal to 0. Okay, this will be, okay, I'm gonna write it over here. We can solve this by using the quadratic formula, okay? Quadratic formula, just wanna see quadratic formula. Okay, we do know that the quadratic formula is given by x equal to minus b plus minus square root of b squared minus 4ac. I always advise students to write the formula even if you know it. Just write it so you can do the right substitution in case it's happened that you forget anything. You know, plus c equal to the quadratic equation. So in this case, we can see that, okay, because we do have 2x squared minus 11x plus 7 equal to 0, right? So now we can see that A is the coefficient of x squared. So A is 2, and then B is negative 11, and then C is 7. Now we can just substitute this in the quadratic formula. Okay, x is would be minus b plus minus square root of b squared minus 4a and then c all over 2a. Now we sum in the values, a is 2 and then b, oops, not a but negative b. So b is negative 11, so negative 11. And then negative 11 to the power of 2 minus 4a, a is 2, and then c is positive 7, and then a is 2. Now we can solve this, simplify this. Negative and negative here makes positive 11 plus minus square root of negative 11 to the power of 2. This is equal to 121 minus. 4 times 2 times 7, this is equal, 4 times 2 is 8, 8 times 7 is 56, not 56 over here, all over 4. And now there it means we have x is equal to 11 plus minus root of 121 minus 56, this is equal to 65 all over 4. And with the negative, we have x is equal to 11 minus, okay, I said positive there, I meant plus or minus here, I meant only plus here, and then minus root 65 also, all over 4. Now, we will going to use a calculator. Okay, to solve this, so now we can use a calculator. I'm gonna show you my calculator here, so you can see. So we will do, or maybe not this calculator. I'll take another calculator at first. Maybe not this one. I'm gonna take another one. Okay, we have the computer here. I'm gonna see we have 11. Okay, let's use this. 11 plus square root of 65 all over 4. Oops, and here over four. So this is the answer we get. This is a 4.76. All these numbers. Just gonna copy the numbers. And let's see here. This is equal to all those numbers. Now, the same way, we can also do with the negative, so we minus there, so we get these numbers. So over here, it's equal to, let's just move. Now you can notice in the question it was like correct to two decimal place. Now how do you do that? Okay, to two decimal place, we are going to like draw a line after the second decimal place in the comma. I'm gonna draw my line here, and then I look at the term that comes, the digit that comes on the right after my line. 5 is greater or equal to 5, right? Because 5 is equal to 5. So let me just write this. 5 equal to 5. So when, because, I think I just want to say 5. Because 5, because it is 5, we must increase the previous digit by 1 unit. Same also here, I count 1, 2, and I draw my line here, the second decimal place. I look the number, it's 4. The number, the digit after my line, and 4, because 4 is lesser than 5, then I will just erase all this. And then here, over here, the answer is just 0.73. But there, the answer will then be, so here x is equal to 0.73. But over here, x will be equal to 4.77 because we rounded up to one decimal to two decimal place. So it was 5 here, we increased this one by 1 more unit. Okay, we can solve the same problem. The same problem can be solved by using by completing this work. Let's just draw a line there. The problem is 2x squared minus 11, 2x squared minus 11, x plus 7 equal to 0. So here it is, 1.1.2 is 2x squared minus 11x plus 7 equal to 0. We can solve this also by completing this point. And what's that? Completing the square. Over here, first we have this 2x squared minus 11x plus 7 equal to 0. Okay. First of all, we're going to move the negative 7 over. Okay. So this will be. To x squared minus 11x equal to negative 7. Okay? Then we will divide the whole equation by 2. So we're going to divide the whole equation by 2. by 2 by 2 there, and then this will be then x squared minus 11 over 2x equal to negative 7 over 2. Now I'm going to write this equation like this, x squared minus 11 over 2x. I'll leave some space on papers and I write negative 7 over 2. This is the moment then I need to find the C value of the quadratic equation, because this is a quadratic equation. We have this quadratic equation in order for us to find the perfect squared. Okay, to have a perfect squared on the left hand side. Now I want to see. Let's see here. C will be okay. The C value is given by negative B over 2. Not negative b, but just b over 2 to the power of 2. Okay, at the moment that we simplify this, then we can do this. C will be equal to, C will be, negative b is negative 11 over 2 already, all over 2. So this is, this part over here, this 11 over 2 is the b, okay, over 2, now to the power of 2. So this will be then c equal to, we're going to write negative 11, oh, change the colors. So c will be negative 11 over 2 times, because the over 2 here is like over 1 also, so we're going to read times by the inverse of the fraction. Remember, a fraction over another fraction is solved like that. We multiply the first fraction by the inverse of the other fraction. So C will be equal to, if you don't see it clearly, let me just erase this. Maybe I'll write it this way, so it must be big enough. Let me see, I'll write C equal to, okay, like that. B is this value here. That's B, okay? The coefficient of X. Remember the quadratic equation. The quadratic equation, we said, the quadratic equation is given by AX squared plus BX plus C equal to zero. Now, B is the coefficient of X. So the coefficient of X here we got, this B is the coefficient of X, and then the coefficient of course of X we get is negative 11 over 2. So now here we're going to write negative 11 over 2, all over 2. Now, divide by 2 is like, 2 itself is like 2 over 1. Okay, to the power of 2. Now, this means C will be equal to negative 11 over 2. To work out the fraction over another fraction, we multiply the first fraction by the inverse of the other fraction. So we do negative 11 over 2 times a half, okay, all to the power of 2. So this is equal to what? Negative 11 over 4 to the power of 2, okay, which is 121 over 16. Now, this is the value we're going to add here. So when I say plus negative 11 over 4 to the power of 2, and then we also plus negative 11 over 4 to the power of 2. Now over here, I don't really need to write that, okay? So I am just going to write plus 121 over 16, because that's negative 11 over 4 to the power of 2. At the moment that I got this basis, okay, same, like we have x squared, and then this also squared, negative 11 over 4 to the power of 2. We can just take the basis like this, x minus 11 over 4 to the power of 2. You can just write like this. The negative 11 over 2x here is included over here. If we extend the equation, okay, you will see the negative 11 over 2, okay? Now, so this will be, equal to what? We can, we need to make, we have negative 7 over 2, right? Plus 121 over 16. So to make it with the same denominator, what we can do, we times here by 8 because we need to have 16. We times there also by 8. Now, this will become, let's just do this. This will become what? X minus 11 over 4 to the power of 2 equal to what? Negative 56 plus 121 over 16, right? Because negative 7 times 8 makes negative 56. And then 2 times 8 is 16. So we do, we add these two together. Now,